Rushing over the clouds and around the world, here comes the wild side of wildlife.
The Animal Show!
And now let's have a wild welcome for your furry friends,
Stinky and Jake!
Now it's the Animal Show!
Right? Ooh, no, yeah, there you go. Hello, all you little animals out there.
I'm Stinky.
And I'm Jake, and today we'll meet two animals with extraordinary beaks. The hornbill and the woodpecker.
Hey, Jake, what do you mean, extraordinary beaks?
Well, I'll tell you, he means this beauty of mine, you see. Can I get a one-shot here, Peter? Oh, thank you, darling. Look at that curve, that sharpness, that patina of perfection.
Yeah, well, you do have a very, very nice beak, Armstrong. Yeah. But the hornbill and the woodpecker have beaks that are really special.
So, in other words, you think my beak is nothing special? I know when I've been insulted.
What? Armstrong,
that's not a very nice thing to say, Jake.
But that's not the way I meant that. Armstrong, Stinky.
Q. Armstrong. Whoa! Hurry, Armstrong! Hurry!
I'm coming. Now it's time for...
That's amazing, Armstrong. Oh, today, the head-rattling work of the woodpecker.
Oh, you mean Mr. Extraordinary Beak.
Take it easy, Armstrong. The woodpecker really does have amazing abilities. He can hammer into a tree 18 times a second without hurting himself.
Hey, that looks painful. How does he do it?
He can do it because there's hardly any space between his brain and his skull, so his brain doesn't bounce around inside.
Well, that's always a good thing.
Second, he's got special padding called cartilage. And third, the muscles and bones of his jaw make sure his beak always hits the tree in a straight line.
Well, I'll be. That really is extraordinary.
The hammering head of the woodpecker.
Another animal that's making me rethink my beak and will make you say...
That's amazing!
Hey, Jake, how come you made fun of Armstrong's beak?
Oh, Stinky, all I said was that today's guests have very special beaks.
And you were absolutely right, Jake. I just saw that woodpecker's beak and I was impressed.
You were?
Yeah, that beak is better than mine. And I'm gonna do something about it.
No, Armstrong, don't do anything crazy.
Well, it's too late to stop him, Jake. Yeah. There's only one thing we can do now. Bring out our first guest.
A good idea. And here she is from Africa and Asia.
Asia.
Hortense, the hornbill.
Oh, that tree almost took my beak off. I simply must be more careful or I'll be a horn without a bill. That was rather amusing.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Well, welcome to the show.
Whoa, that is some beak you got there. Whoa.
Oh, thank you, Stinky. We hornbills are rather proud of our beaks. Allow me to show you.
Don't tell me you brought footage.
Indeed. This is a yellow-billed hornbill, one of six species. We range in size from as small as a blackbird to as large as a turkey.
Why is this hornbill feeding that tree?
Oh, Stinky, he isn't feeding the tree. That father hornbill is bringing food to the mother hornbill and their chicks.
The mother and chicks live inside a tree?
Naturally. See, here is the mother hornbill closing up the entrance. She uses her beak to spread clay and mud like a mason smoothing out cement.
But why would she want to close herself up inside that tree?
After a mother hornbill lays her eggs, she seals herself in the tree for 7 weeks until the eggs have hatched and the chicks can take care of themselves.
Well, now, how can she and the chicks live inside a tree for 7 weeks? What do they eat?
That is father hornbill's job. He will make between 40 and 50 trips a day, bringing food to mother and the chicks. Berries, figs, fruits, even insects and lizards. He can carry it all in that extraordinary beak of his.
Where did Mom go?
As soon as the mother hornbill leaves the nest, the young chicks immediately begin to rebuild their wall, all by themselves. As they get bigger, they will each break the wall and leave the nest one by one.
Well, I can sure see why they say the hornbills have amazing beaks. You can use them to get food, to defend yourself, even to build a wall.
Yeah, but how do you fly with such a big beak?
Oh, good question, Stinky. Despite its large size, our beak is surprisingly lightweight. Otherwise, we'd be terribly top-heavy and never get off the ground.
So I guess you'd say that the best kind of beak for a bird to have is a big beak, right?
Oh, I'm rather fond of big beaks myself. But birds with small beaks can also be quite extraordinary, too. Take, for instance, my friend, the Puffin.
Okay, where do you want us to take him?
No, I just mean I want to show you some pictures of puffins.
Wow, what a beautifully colored beak.
Oh, yes, the puffin's beak turns lovely colors in the spring. That's a signal to other puffins that these birds are ready to breed. After breeding season, the puffin's beak will turn a dull gray with a yellow tip.
Now, what is this puffin here doing?
He's gathering grass and twigs and other nesting material to use in their underground nest as a cushion for the eggs and to keep their chicks warm. And now he will bring that grass down to the nest to warm up the little chick.
That's a little puffin chick. He's huge.
Oh, yes. Puffins feed their young very, very well. There's mother with some more sand eels for her baby to eat. My puffin friend tells me they're delicious. And when that chick is old enough, he'll come out and float on the wind just like these puffins here are doing.
Well, with the size of that chick, it'd better be a big wind.
Well, Hortense, thank you for telling us all about hornbills, puffins, and their extraordinary beaks.
Did you say extraordinary beaks? Get a load of mine. It's the woodpecker look. What do you think?
Well, I, for one, think it's far too dull. I think you'd be much better off with a beak like mine.
Oh. Yeah, that is a rather prominent proboscis you have there. What do you think? Tell me about it a little bit. Tell me something.
Oh, most certainly. Walk this way.
Oh. Hortense! Armstrong!
It's too late, Jake. There's only one thing to do now. Huh? It's time for...
Baby talk!
Your turn!
No problem, dear. I got it covered. Right. Here we go. Hello? Hello in there. Here's some nice vegetation for you to eat.
Thanks, Dad. More.
If you're sure, listen to that. Don't they have lovely voices?
So, Jake, what did you think of Armstrong's woodpecker beak?
Well, there's a lot more to being a woodpecker than just a beak. You need a hard head.
Well, I've got a hard head. Here, give it a try.
Okay. Wow, with a head like that, you ought to be in this next song.
Do you hear bells ringing?
Folks like us, we don't make no fuss. We don't scream or scratch or shout. We just knock a few heads together. That sorts the whole thing out. We don't go in for no fancy talk when there's something. Decide who's best and all that stuff. So we knock a few heads together to see who's really tough. Some folks discuss their point of view politely over tea, but we knock a few heads together and the problem QED.
I'm Wanda Rat, World Reporter, getting you answers to today's tough questions. Let's see if one of these animals knows the answer. Sir, can you answer a question?
You're kidding? Does a dog have fleas?
Please, sir, I ask the questions.
Okay.
Right. This is a yellow-billed hornbill. Can you tell me how many different species of hornbill there are? Now, can you answer my question?
No, but I can answer mine. This dog definitely has fleas.
Answer to my question.
Oh, my goodness.
There are six species of hornbill, including the ground, the upper guinea, the yellow-billed, and the red-billed. Let's take a closer look at the ground hornbill. As its name suggests, ground hornbills live on the ground. They can be found living on the ground in Africa on the steppes and savannas. They prefer to live where the grass is short because it's easier to find food. They walk along together in small parties looking for food, and they rarely fly. The ground hornbill is the only species of hornbill where the female is not imprisoned inside the nest hole. She therefore has to molt in stages and must support herself when breeding. Ground hornbills eat mostly small vertebrates and large insects. As you can see, they also eat snakes and have incredible eyelashes. This is Rhonda Rat reporting on the ground hornbill. Back to you, Stinky and Jake.